Today we learn about a very interesting concept of logarithm. What is that? Suppose you have log a to the base b. We know logs exist in such forms, log 4 to the base 2. Okay. Now, with the help of this, can you tell me how can we find out the opposite, like log b to the base a? That is, for example, log 2 to the base 4. So, they interchange their places. Well, this is a very easy number. You can even tell that yourself. But suppose if it is a big number, you are given this and you are asked this just with the help of whatever is given. Then how will we do that? Well, there is one formula known as the reciprocal formula for such situations. But how did we get that? First, we'll see that. What we will do is put m is equal to b and let's see what happens. So, log b to the base a is equal to log, we are putting m as b, so b to the base b by log a to the base b. How will it help us? Well, it will ease our work. See, log b to the base a is equal to log b to the base b. What will be the answer? It will be 1. We know log b to the base b or log a to the base a, if they have the same base as a number here, the answer is always 1. So 1 by log a to the base b. See, this is actually what we wanted. Look, log b to the base a is actually equal to 1 by log a to the base b. See, here both have interchanged their places. So this is what we call the reciprocal formula. See, log b to the base a is equal to 1 by log a to the base b. Where can you use it? Well, actually, whenever you will do sums and you will be given such logs in the denominator. Now, such things don't look good. It looks good in the numerator. So, if you want to bring it up to the numerator, you can just interchange the places of the base and the number given here and put the denominator in the numerator. Or if you want, for the ease of your sums, you can also do the opposite. Now, tell me, log 5 to the base 10. Using the reciprocal formula, how will it look? 1 by log 10 to the base 5. Like this. So, this is how we use the reciprocal formula. Now, does this actually work? Like, the answer is really same or not? Let's check. We know log 8 to the base 2, what will be the answer? It will be 2 into 2 into 2, 2 multiplied with itself 3 times. Right? Now, what if I want to find the opposite? See, if this is A and this is B. So, log A to the base B. Now, I am changing their positions. So, log B to the base A. See, you can see I am changing their positions. Now, what will be the answer of this? Tell me, 8 multiplied with itself, how many times will give you 2? Well, 2 is a small number. So, that means the power that will come on 8 will be a smaller or a fraction. 8 cube rooted 3 times gives you 2. Am I correct? 2 into 2 into 2, 8. So, that means 8 cube rooted gives you 2. Or you can say 8 to the power 1 by 3 gives you 2. Right? So, we get log 2 to the base 8 is 1 by 3. So, see, do you get the relation here? I told you that the reciprocal formula is what? 1 by this. So, log 8 to the base 2 is 3 and log 2 to the base 8 is 1 by 3. So, see, you get the reciprocal of what you were getting before. That means log a to the base b is equal to 1 by log b to the base a. Right? So, this is proven. Now, see, we have been given such a sum. 1 by log n to the base a plus 1 by log n to the base c. Suppose you go to do it the normal fraction, that addition of fraction way, it will become very difficult to solve. So, what we will do is, we will apply the reciprocal formula to take the denominator and make it the numerator of here. So do this, tell me, how will you convert this to the numerator, or how will you apply the reciprocal formula to turn these two? See, log n to the base a becomes log a to the base n, plus log c n to the base c becomes log c to the base n. So this is how you convert. Now suppose I tell you that log a to the base n plus log c to the base n is equal to 2 by log n to the base b. Can you also apply the reciprocal formula here? Well, obviously you can apply. Tell me, how will you apply the reciprocal formula to this? Just interchange their places. Right? Now, if you have log a to the base n plus log c to the base n is equal to 2 log b to the base n, you can see all the bases here are now same. Prove ac is equal to b square. Well, how will you prove that? Prove ac is equal to b square. Well, you just need a quick recap of the previous three standard laws of logarithm we had learnt. Remember the product law and the power law? Well, here you have to use that. Tell me, how will you prove this? Look at LHS first. See, log a to the base n plus log c to the base n. We need ac. So actually what you need to do is apply the product law, but in a different way. You remember the product law? What does it state? Log mn to the base a is equal to log m to the base a plus log n to the base a. Now we will apply it the opposite way. So log a to the base n plus log c to the base n can be written as log ac to the base n. Right? Now look at the RHS part. 2 log b to the base n. Remember the power law, where what do? We bring the power to in front of the logarithm. What we will do is take back this power here. So this becomes log b square to the base n. Now you know that log x is equal to log y. If log x is equal to log y, then x is equal to y, right? So the same thing goes here. This is log x with the same base is equal to log y to the same base n. So we can derive that ac is equal to b square. So this is where we come to the end of our solution. So you see how reciprocal formula helps in performing operations in logarithm.